this knowledge of this Jesus who has risen from the dead, and the commandment at the end of the gospel today is to go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel, the good news, to every creature. Every creature. And I think that at the same time, it calls us to be bold about our faith, to be committed to our faith, to be strong about the faith. For we know that these disciples of Jesus were willing to give their own lives rather than betray the faith that was handed down to them. They were willing to die for Jesus, to show how important this faith is, and that for others it did not make sense, but for them it was everything they had, to the point that they were willing to give their precious life for it. Often I hear, you know, people say to me, "Father, you know, how can we as a church reach out to others so that, you know, they get to know Jesus?" Or, "Father, you're not doing enough. You're not doing enough to bring converts into the church." Is to live out Christ in our lives. To bring people to love Jesus because they experience the love we have, and that we are willing to live our lives every day following the footsteps of Jesus. Anybody can read the catechism. Anybody can examine the catechism. And that's great, and that's fine. But the first thing we must do as a Christian community is to be bold. And you have the courage to be bold by living what Jesus has taught us first in our own lives. And when we start living that in our own lives, people will look and people will stare. And what are those things that we must follow as a Catholic Christian community? But the first thing we must do is to allow other people to fall in love with Jesus. And I think that being bold about our faith, because we have to be convinced. Jesus rebuked them because why? Because they did not believe those who ran back and said, "Hey, we have seen Jesus." And they're like, Yeah. First of all, you're just a woman. What would you know, Mary Magdalene, about that? No, that's not possible. He would appear to us. We are men. And of course, the Lord teaches us a great lesson. Who does he appear to first? A woman. And there's nothing wrong with that. And then the next, it tells us, in a different way, he appeared to those two men who were on the road to Emmaus. And they didn't recognize him until then, what? Until the breaking of the bread. And the conversation that they have to each other, and if you read it carefully, what does it say?